This is your Bible Geeks Daily Download into the book, Acts chapters 22 through 26.
In the early 90s, NBC introduced a new procedural show called Law and Order. 30 years later, the franchise has 6 spin-offs and has produced over 1,000 episodes. Known for its rip-from-the-headlines storylines and familiar two-note signature sound, the show blends plot twists with a familiar pattern. The first half of the show follows the investigation, while the second half focuses on the trial.
Like a serialized court drama, this week's readings in Acts will offer a series of trials, one after another. Episode 1, The Crowd, from Acts chapter 22. While not an official trial, the week's readings begin with Paul asking a mob of Jews at the temple steps to hear the defense he will make before them. Acts chapter 22, verse 1. What details does he emphasize about Ananias, Jesus, and his conversion?
Episode 2 features the trial before the Sanhedrin in Acts 23. The High Court of the Jews consisted of both Pharisees and Sadducees, two parties fiercely split on the issue of the resurrection of the dead. How does Paul deftly play them against one another?
And then in Episode 3, we find Felix in Acts chapter 24. Now in the coastal cities of Caesarea, the Roman seat of government in that area, Paul makes his case before the governor of Judea, Marcus Antonius Felix. What topics alarmed Felix in Acts chapter 25, verse 25?
In episode 4, we find the trial before Festus in Acts 25. Felix leaves the matter for the next governor, Porcius Festus, who ruled over Judea from 60 to 62 AD. What dilemmas do these rulers face as they try to render a verdict on Paul, as we read about in Acts 25, verses 18 to 20?
And then in episode 5, we find Agrippa in Acts chapter 26. When Festus hosts King Agrippa II and his wife, the king asks to hear from Paul. Why do you think he gives Agrippa more details?
And the story will continue from here in Acts 27 to 28, as Paul appeals to Caesar, Nero at this time, which will ultimately bring him to the political capital of the world to make his case for the way of Christ.
But of course, there's plenty of plot twists. These chapters have their share of plot twists and twisted plots. In Monday's reading in Acts chapter 22, as the Jews riot over Paul's speech, the Roman soldiers decide to flog and interrogate Paul. What does Paul reveal that stops them and changes the course of events for the rest of the book?
In Tuesday's reading in Acts 23, a plot to assassinate Paul gets thwarted when Paul's nephew discovers it and they alert a centurion. What promise did the Lord make to Paul right before the conspiracy came to light? How do these efforts of evil men end up facilitating the Lord's purposes?
But it all follows a familiar pattern. In our readings in Luke, we emphasize the Lord's journey to Jerusalem. As Paul made his trip to Jerusalem, he too knew that suffering awaited him. In this week's chapters, we'll see that Paul, like our Lord, will face 4 trials before rulers. Despite all this, both Jesus and Paul are declared innocent 3 times in Luke and Acts.
Why do you think Luke has emphasized the parallels in the lives of Jesus and his follower Paul? And what differences could we note?
So let's step into the courtroom this week in Acts chapters 22 through 26, and may the Lord bless you and keep you today.
Shalom.